Hello and welcome to MacEdu YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you how you can install macOS Mojave on an older Mac. As you can see, I'm running macOS Mojave on a mid-2010 MacBook Pro, which is not supported on Apple's website for macOS Mojave, and it is running very smooth as compared to High Sierra. So sit back, relax, and now onto the video. This install was possible by DOSDude1, who created the macOS Mojave patcher, and links to his website and YouTube channel can be found in the video description. So this method would work on a large number of Macs as early as 2008, but there are some versions that are not supported, which can be found in the description of the video. So basically there are two ways to install macOS Mojave. Either you can upgrade or you can do a clean install. If you decide to do a clean install, make sure your files are backed up. So before we start, we need to check the Wi-Fi card on your Mac, as some of the older Macs have a Wi-Fi that won't work on macOS Mojave. Also, we need to check the SIP status, which we will discuss later in the video. First, let's check the Wi-Fi card. Select the launchpad and go to the other folder, and now open system information. Now scroll down and select Wi-Fi and check the card type. Fun fact, my Wi-Fi broke down at the time of this recording. This was a hardware failure, nothing to do with macOS Mojave, but my Wi-Fi is fully supported. I had issues with the Wi-Fi card and it eventually stopped working. So if we can get 50 likes on this video, I will make a video on replacing my Wi-Fi card. But you will have a Wi-Fi card type right here. And here's a list of unsupported Wi-Fi card. If your Wi-Fi is on the list, then your Wi-Fi won't work on macOS Mojave. In this situation, you either will need to change the Wi-Fi card or get a USB Wi-Fi dongle that should work on macOS Mojave. I will link it in the video description. But if your Wi-Fi isn't on the list, your Wi-Fi will work on macOS Mojave. Now let's create a USB installer for Mojave. To create a USB installer, you will need a USB drive with 16 gigs or more. So if your Mac is unsupported, there is a chance you won't be able to download macOS Mojave from the Apple App Store. To download Mojave, we need to download macOS Mojave patcher from the links in the video description. After the download is complete, open macOS Mojave patcher.dmg. After you open the macOS Mojave patcher, you'll be greeted with this window. Click open. Now you can download macOS Mojave. Just go to tools and click on download macOS Mojave. While the Mojave is downloading, let's format the USB drive. Hit command plus spacebar and type in disk utility. Now click here and select show all devices. After that, select your USB drive and click on erase tab. As USB name, you can type any name you want. As format, choose Mac OS extended journal. As scheme, select GUID partition map. And now press erase to erase the USB drive. After the USB is erased, close the disk utility app. So after the macOS Mojave is downloaded, open macOS Mojave patcher again and click here to select the macOS Mojave file you just downloaded. And here you can select the USB drive that we have just formatted. After that is done, click on start operation. After the setup is complete, close down the patcher and now we will restart the Mac. Hit the option key as soon as you hear the startup sound and select your USB drive and hit enter. Wait for a few seconds and now we will disable the SIP status. So open terminal from here and type csr util space status and hit enter. If the SIP status is disabled, then you can proceed. But if the SIP status is enabled, we need to disable the SIP status first. To disable the SIP status, type csr util space disable and hit enter. You will receive a message that SIP status is disabled, and we will restart the Mac once more. Again, hit option key as soon as you hear the startup sound and select the USB drive. Now after a few seconds, you will be on the setup menu. If you want to upgrade, just go through the setup. But if you want to do a clean install, you need to erase the drive first. Click on disk utility from bottom left corner. Now click here and select show all devices. Select your hard drive and click on erase. As name, you can type anything, and as format you have two options. If your Mac model is 2009 or above, you can choose APFS. If you have an older Mac model, then go with macOS Extended Journal. As scheme, in both cases, choose GUID partition map. Now hit erase and erase your hard drive and make sure to backup files before this step. After that, close disk utility and now you can proceed with the setup. Press continue. Now select your hard drive from here and select continue. The installation process may take 30 minutes to about an hour. After the installation, you may or may not see this logo, but do not panic, this is fine. You simply restart your Mac and hold down option key as soon as you hear the startup sound and select your USB drive, and after a few seconds, from bottom left corner, select Mac post install. Okay, from here you can choose your Mac model. From here you can select your hard drive where Mojave is installed, and all the mandatory options for your Mac will be selected, but you can customize if you want. After that, click on patch and now we can reboot. Now you will boot in macOS Mojave. Just type in your Apple ID, and after you agree with Apple's terms and condition, you will be greeted to the home screen of Mojave. With time, new driver updates will be available, which can be performed by macOS Mojave patcher, and that can be found in launchpad under other folder. As you can see, we have successfully downloaded macOS Mojave on a mid-2010 MacBook Pro. If you liked the video, please subscribe and share the video to support our channel. As always, stay positive and I will see you in the next one.